All right, so Night Eagles as the blue side up north, PP, of course, as the orangish, beige-ish color. What color is that, honestly?
You know, it's like between orange and yellow. It's like a darkish yellow, sort of. It's not exactly orange.
And I feel like
either,
it's like a different color on every screen as well.
That is
like
possible.
When I look at, when I watch the stream online, it's like a completely different color as what we see. In any case, yes, look at this tank lineup. Pretty interesting, yeah.
Very interesting.
Wow.
A slightly lighter setup for PP Super Friends. That's very ambitious. A pair of T69s, a pair of 1390s.
Oh my god, look at this.
T32.
CK could be in some trouble right now.
No, he won't.
He might take some damage, though, because Robin and Batman could light
up.
No,
because audio on just... He's got a cross right now, though. He's got a cross right now.
But look at this. Ace Ward, a little leg. All right there to do damage.
Oh!
One more shot.
One more shot.
Yeah, he gets taken out. He was way too forward.
Once again,
right
there. It's a mistake we had seen yesterday, pretty much. Why
would you cross?
Why would you cross the railroad?
Yeah,
exactly. Why would you cross the railroad? And he was actually against the Night Eagles.
Oh my god, this could be over, actually.
You know,
losing. Oh my god.
I can't believe the Night Eagles made exactly the same mistake as Yorimen did yesterday, playing against them. Oh, as a matter of fact, it's just. And once again. Yeah, you're right. I think this is over. Because
losing a tier 8 like that
from the get-go on a map like Rock Rock,
really detrimental for your team because, and especially they didn't even do any damage onto any of the PvP members, so that trade was for nothing essentially on the Night Eagle side, and they have to do something. They have to get outnumbering situations at this point, and they cannot afford to split their forces
anymore, which is a big
disadvantage.
They have to engage the enemy right now. If they want
to catch Antera right here. But the thing is, if they try and catch him here, the PvP side has all of their tanks. Look at that lineup on their team. You can't see it, but Antare has his entire team kind of in a bow shape around him.
Exactly, and he's got plenty of cover.
Look at that right now. Look at that lineup.
He's forcing them to cross, and look at all the damage that the Night Eagles...
Wow.
I mean, they don't even have to cross. N60 is like down to 40%. He's almost down, as a matter of fact. It's game over. 100%.
They still have not done any damage onto any of the PvP members. Antare is not even afraid to go into that spot against... Four of those.
No, he's just providing excellent vision for the rest of his team. He doesn't even have to fire a single shot, and he hasn't, as a matter of fact.
Oh, N60 about to go down here. 320 health. Audio, he's still pretty healthy. Lunar Maria is down to about 850. So.
Everyone has taken shots.
Yeah.
Everyone has taken damage, and N60 is probably going to be the first one to go down here. Because he had crossed the field, and yeah, this is just an overwhelming victory for PvP Super Friends. I can't help but just feel that the Night Eagles are ruefully regretting their misplay on mines for set number two. That would have given them like a 2-to-love lead, and I really think this set is just has crippled them mentally a little bit. They feel the pressure a little too much right now.
Right, possibly. Yeah, I mean that early kill on CKSB kind of just
no. I mean that was fatal.
That was like
the final nail in the coffin. That
really
was just game over from the very get-go, pretty much. There is no way that you can come back from an 8-tier point disadvantage.
Oh, there we go. Another tank getting down. And there we go. The second AMX 13 N60 going down. Right there. They do trade for a T1, but still, honestly, yeah, this is like 90% gonna go to PvP.
I'd say 100%. No, there's not even like a 1% chance that they can come back because ultimately they will have to engage. They will have to engage because of the tier point difference. And look at that. Everybody took so much damage. And Taro, who's in the front lines, barely had a third of his life taken down.
Yeah, whereas Lunar Maria down to 600.
It is an overwhelming victory.
It's over.
It's game over. Oh, yeah. I mean, there's nothing, absolutely nothing that the Night Eagle members can do.
And PvP, they're not even risking going in right now. They're still just continuing to throw down
this
long-range harassment.
Slowly
have that slow finisher, that safe... Like risk-free, 100% win.
Indeed, and look at that. Batman just going for a flank. Now they're gonna go in. Ultimately, Batman and Robin are just gonna start shooting. From the northernmost part of the railroad, and that's gonna give them an extra angle. And it's just, it's game over. I mean, really, there's nothing.
Ace Rooter starting to take damage right now, but it's not. Gonna
it's not gonna matter.
Matter.
It's not gonna matter at all, really.
Yeah, look at that.
I'd be very surprised I'd be very surprised if PvP lost to any tier 8s at this point.
Yeah.
I don't think
all
they're
the
gonna
tanks
lose.
Are so incredibly healthy.
Yeah,
though.
Yeah, they're not going to lose anybody.
I don't believe how one-sided this is going. I mean, I kind of understand.
I mean,
I don't know why.
Because that 13 KSBB went down.
But at the same time, I mean, usually even if you lose like a tier 8 that early on, if you push right, like in the right way, you can at least get, you know, one or two of those tier 8s down.
Yeah, but it's just the PvP positioning that was phenomenal.
Yeah, that's
that,
true. That's
on
that
field.
That,
the only
that
way
formation, man.
Exactly. And
impenetrable.
The only way that you can engage them is just to charge in like and